Welcome to another video from explainingcomputers.com. Once again, my happy friends at LeMaker have been launching new products, and so in this video, I'm going to introduce you to their brand new Banana Pro. Right, here I am with my exciting DHL package from halfway around the world. I always find it fascinating how far some of this hardware travels. So let's get inside. Do it the easy way with some scissors, which is... Why can I never get into things easily? There we are. Aha! And here we have the Banana Pro itself. So, let's get the thing open. Here we are. Oh, look, a little Banana Pro little leaflet. That's nice. This will be an antenna. An antenna, you cry. What's that for? We'll come back to that a bit later. And then inside the box itself, as you can see, we have got, as you would expect, the computer in its little bag. So if I open up the bag, we can get the thing out, and there we are. This is a Banana Pro. If we put it down next to its cousin, the Banana Pi over here, we can see some of the differences. They do look very similar boards, particularly on the top. This is a bluish colour, the Banana Pro is a blackish colour. Sadly, they couldn't make it a yellowish colour to be a banana colour, but I'm sure that doesn't really matter. Anyway, what have they changed? Well, on the top, there's not a lot of differences. You can still see here we've got the gigabit Ethernet, we've still got two USB 2 ports, we've still got an IR module, we've still got a microphone just in here. We've still got a camera connector, a display connector. We've still got our HDMI socket. We've still got our SATA port. Hurrah! We've still got SATA power and USB micro connector to power the board. And on the back, a USB OTG connector and some reset and power switches. But what is different, as you probably noticed, is the Banana Pro has got 40 pins for its GPIO header to make it a bit more like the Raspberry Pi Model B Plus. And also, they've integrated, as again happened between different models of Raspberry Pi, they've taken the composite video connector and the audio jack and integrated them into this very slimline combined composite audio and video jack. However, to really get the impression of what is new about the Banana Pro, what we have to do is to turn the boards over. So if we flick them over like this, you'll see the real thing that's altered is to do with, for example, storage. We used to have a SD card slot here, a standard size SD card slot on the Banana Pi. On the Banana Pro, this has become a micro SD slot. We've still got the same chip, the A20 all-winner processor, dual-core processor. We've still got a gigabyte of RAM in these two Samsung chips. But the real killer thing on the Banana Pro is this. What is this, I hear you cry? Well, this is actually a Wi-Fi module. Yes, the Banana Pro has got integrated Wi-Fi. And as you can probably see, there's even a tiny little connector down here to connect in an external antenna. This, of course, takes us back to the exciting bubble wrap thing that we had in the box at the start. Never get into exciting bubble wrap things. Remember, you always have to have your scissors handy. Scissors are very, very handy things when you want to cut things open. You probably know that, don't you? Anyway, if we open this up, somewhere in here, we have this. Yes, this is our Wi-Fi antenna, which has on it the tiny, weird little connector, which will connect onto our board. I should make it clear, I've been told to make it clear by LeMaker, this actually might not be the final product. This is a potentially just a temporary one they've sent me until the board is finalised. Right, it's now high time to start putting things together. So I just thought I'd show you everything I'm going to be using in terms of hardware here. Clearly we've got the Banana Pro itself and its antenna and its little booklet in case I need to refer to that. We've also got a USB power adapter. Remember, you need ideally 2 amps to power a Banana Pro, but an amp and a half will I'm sure be fine in most circumstances. You're also going to need a tiny little micro SD card. Well, in fact, a normal size micro SD card, they just happen to be tiny. And here, I'm actually going to be using as well an SSD. This is a fairly old SSD from Corsair. It'll be perfectly sufficient for these purposes. I know a lot of you are very interested in the use of SSDs or 2.5-inch drives on the Banana Pro. And to hold all this together, I've got these brackets, which you may know I actually made in my previous video when I looked at the old LeMaker 2 and what it could print out. So these are all the bits to put things together, and of course some screws there in the corner. So if I just engage in a little bit of construction, putting the sides onto the SSD, connecting the Wi-Fi antenna, screwing the board on top of the mount, and then adding in the SATA cable that for some reason I forgot to show you before, we'll end up with our Banana Pro all mounted to the SSD, all raring to go, and all waiting to have an operating system. Right, I've now gone to the LeMaker website, where I'll go to Resources, and I'll select Downloads, and I'm going to download the latest version of Android for the Banana Pro. You'll notice on the LeMaker site now the default is to download for Banana Pro. You can still get to Banana Pi files if you wish them. But here I want Android for Banana Pro. I'll download via the Google Drive link and save that to my computer. And then I'm going to use Phoenix card when this file is actually downloaded to copy it to my micro SD card. I showed you that in more detail in a previous video. Then, of course, the card will want to be inserted into the Banana Pro. It'll want to be connected up to HDMI for a display, to power. I'm also going to connect in a mouse and a keyboard. And then we can boot up into Android, which is exactly what you can see going on here. Isn't it amazing how quickly things can happen in a video? Anyway, here we are in Android, and what I want to try and do is to see if we can get onto Wi-Fi, because, of course, the Wi-Fi module is our most interesting thing here. So I'm going to settings. If I open up, turn Wi-Fi on, it'll look for some Wi-Fi networks. And one of them might even be mine. I live in a block of flats, so I can see lots of different Wi-Fi networks, not necessarily ones I want. And there we are, we've got CJB Net, you would have guessed is me. So I just need to put in my password. And at moments like this, I wish it wasn't so long. Last digit is a 1, therefore key information, connect. And I'm connected, I'm on Wi-Fi it seems, which is clearly amazing. Back somewhere on this, and we can find, say, a browser. Looks like it might be going somewhere. Don't know what Android is doing, but oh, it's found Google, that must be good news. But we will try, of course, the world's favorite website. And there we are. We are now running in Android on Wi-Fi on a Banana Pro. It all seems to be working very well indeed. Isn't that quite amazing? It seems to actually work. That's fantastic. Final thing I'm going to do, just because some of you are interested and I happen to be here, is to go back home again. And I'm going to go to, say, File Manager over there. And I'll go and click on SATA. I know many of you are interested to see, can you read a SATA drive in Android on a Banana Pi stroke Pro? And you clearly can. Let's just check, there are some files we can see here. There's some tests, I think are just JPEGs, they are, look. And this will prove, yes, we can read a JPEG file on our Banana Pro. So there we are. We've got the Banana Pro running, it's got Wi-Fi working, it can see a SATA drive. That, I think, for today is a very good set of tests. For anybody who needs a SATA port and an integrated Wi-Fi module, the Banana Pro has to be the best single board computer. In a future video, I hope to use it to show you how to build a wireless NAS drive. But now that's it for this time, and I hope to talk to you again very soon.